the message which these unofficial diplomats of the youth from behind the Iron Curtain delivered to General Eisenhower is going to be carried, of course, by Radio Free Europe, which is broadcasting to the countries in Central and Eastern Europe enslaved today, and also by Voice of America, which is broadcasting to all countries in the world. And I'm sure that this is going to be the main event in Central and Eastern Europe, when they are going to hear that they are not forgotten, and that some representatives, absolutely unofficial and just symbolically representing those countries here, had the chance to give their hope, the message of hope, to the general and to the American people.
It would be difficult to express the feelings of a fellow coming home again after having been gone for some months in Europe. The nicest thing that's happened to me for a long, long time is this weekend, which I've been able to spend with my children, my grandchildren, with my wife. It's been the loveliest thing could have happened. Now I'm ready to go to work again, which I understand I'm going to do tomorrow morning. And from then on, I'm going to be very busy till I take off on Tuesday back.